Double Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, let's move up to some heavyweights. And I'm just going to say this. The biggest upset of the weekend. This biggest upset in the weekend might fly under the radar, but get your antennas up, right? You had a fight against Martin Bacoli, right? Versus Michael Hunter. Heavyweights. Michael Hunter used to be cruiserweight. Get up to heavyweight for this fight. Right now, Martin Bacoli, he's from Congo, right? Got royalty in his family. Matter of fact, you know, he's coming to America up in here, you know. And he's about 6'6", about 255, right? About 255 and 11-0. And a lot of people, you know, were talking very, very highly about this guy, right? Because he's got very good technique. He's good, he's big, right? And his claim to fame is he sparred 150 rounds with Anthony Joshua. And, you know, word has it that he does very well, okay? He does very well. Now, Michael Hunter is, 14-1, but his only loss is to Oleksandr Usyk, who is boxing royalty right now because he's undisputed cruiserweight champion. It means he beats everybody. And Usyk beats everybody in their house, which makes him even more off. He don't have no wins at his home. All of them away, right? And still undisputed, which means you are beating people convincingly because you're beating them in front of their families at their home and everybody's screaming for them. That's why Usyk gets much props, right? Because it's not happening at home where people are all, where you throw a jab and everybody's screaming. He doesn't have that. You know what I'm saying? He convinces the opponent's crowd that he beats them, which makes him awesome. So you can lose to that. Everybody else got beat by my father, right? So, you know, it's only 14-1, but that's just letting you know. So, you know, Michael Hunter goes in here and upsets your boy, Martin Bacoli, right? Upsets the big man, stops him in the last round, barrage of punches, right? Now, what was interesting about the fight is early, you would think because there was a speed difference, right? Your boy Hunter was definitely faster. So he comes in the fight and he stays in the pocket and trades with this guy faster, you know, hit him with some good shots early, right? But you would think that he would just stay on the outside for a while, wait this guy to get tired because Bacoli's never been 10 rounds. It's his first 10-round fight for Bacoli, right? So it was interesting to see him in the pocket early trading with this big guy. Hit him more than he got hit. But he was in there. He didn't have to do that. And his coach said even after the fight, I seen Rockman. You know Rockman, who that is. If you don't know him, you should know. Rockman's the one who beat my boy, Lennox Lewis, right? First fight, right? So I seen Rockman as a heavyweight champion. So former heavyweight champion. So that's his trainer. And Rockman was like, man, he could have outboxed this guy. I think my man had too much courage early. We didn't have to get hit that much. So this is a very, very impressive win. Very impressive win, guys. Go check it out. This is the kind of stuff to let you know that these smaller guys that think they can beat these bigger guys, this is an example of it. Because your boy, Michael Hunter, but about 215 pounds. Bacoli is, what is he? 6'6", about 255, like I said. You know, 30-something pounds there, guys. See what I'm saying? And to get in there and handle your business, this is the kind of thing that makes you think. Oleksandr Usyk thinks he can beat Anthony Joshua. Now you see why he would think that. Shoot, I beat Michael Hunter, who beats the dude who hangs in, who has good sparring against Anthony Joshua. You see what I'm saying? So that's why he would probably think that. So this is very, very good. Now, after having a fight like that, after winning a fight like that, Michael Hunter is thinking, well, you know, maybe I will try go back to Great Britain and fight some of the other heavyweights, the Derek Chisora's of the world and the Dillian Whites of the world. I seen Rockman has said, well, you know, we ain't going to sit here and call out no Anthony Joshua or nothing like that because you got to earn that. So he says, let's go ahead and try to get one of those guys, Dillian White or Derek Chisora. And he said either one of the Furies, but he's not going to try to call out Anthony Joshua because you got to earn that. I think they've got their heads or their feet planted in the ground, right? And that's what's good. That's what I like to hear because, you know, they're not getting ahead of themselves. It's a good win. And let me tell you, Bacoli was touted, okay? I heard what's going on with this guy. He was touted. He was supposed to beat him and do a whole lot of other stuff quickly. Now they're going to have to pull him back and say, hold up. take a couple of harder fights. You know, make sure you get that stamina for the second half of those fights. Those kind of things. He has good technique. And let Michael Hunter tell it. He has great skill. He's very strong. All of those good things. But, you know, speed. It showed you that speed does kill. Michael Hunter had more speed. And he had the courage to let them hands go against a big guy, a thudding puncher. Awesome win, guys. Go check that out. Michael Hunter defeats your boy Martin Bukoli, 10th round stoppage. Awesome. The upset of the weekend, probably of the month. Doma Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.